Rocket Lab says the $8.3 million provincial growth fund investment in Mahia roadworks will allow the space company to launch 120 rockets a year. The PGF announcement at Mahia's Tua Huru Marae yesterday included a $7 million grant to seal a 12.5-kilometre section of Mahia East Coast Road, which leads to the space company's launch complex at the tip of the peninsula. Launch complex manager Chuck Dowdle told those gathered at the Marae that Rocket Lab was licensed to launch 120 times a year from Mahia Peninsula, and improving road access to the site would allow it to realise that intent.
Our missions have injected about $18 million into the local community, and that's through employment. We are the largest employer in Mahia at the moment, and that's going to increase in future.
Better road access would lead to more jobs and more investment in local businesses, he said. The $8.3 million investment announced by Parliamentary Undersecretary for Regional Economic Development, Fletcher Tabatow, includes a $1 million grant to seal 4 kilometres of private road on Onenui Station, where Rocket Lab's launch complex is based.
Quite fundamentally, the road needs an upgrade, and it needs to be safer and more accessible. And so that comes back to the fundamental questions of economic development. It's a statement to the locals and anyone who wants to live here, we'll look after you, the infrastructure's going to be here long term. But it's also a statement to people outside of the area, come and visit, come and see what's so exciting and so beautiful about these parts.
A second launch pad at the complex is due to be built by the end of the year. A local man at the Marae questioned why works on the road were starting at the end of the peninsula, despite a couple of significant washouts on earlier sections of the route into Mahia. In response, Mr. Tabatow pointed to the $300,000 grant, also part of yesterday's announcement, to investigate the realignment of the peninsula's main access road from Nuhaka to Opotama, which has been reduced to one lane for months after a washout at Black's Beach. Wairoa Mayor Craig Little said the council needed to work out how the road should be fixed before forging ahead with remedial works.
There's no point fixing it and then it's going to fall in the river tomorrow. Yeah. So we've got to actually work out how it's going to happen and then work it. So they can expect there'll be some work, but it may not be fixing it yet. They might come back and say, actually, you can fix it how it is. But we have to, as a council, do full due diligence first before we do fix anything.
He also hinted that another PGF windfall for the district may be in the wings. This follows January's announcement of $4.8 million for the rejuvenation of Wairoa's main street, Marine Parade. You could tell it was an election year yesterday, with Napier MP Stuart Nash and Ikaroa Rāwhiti MP Meka Waitiri, both of the Labour Party, they're in support of New Zealand First Mr. Tabatow, and both sides praising the coalition that allowed the PGF to get off the ground. The politicians were hosted by Rongo Mai Wahine Iwi Trust, whose chief executive, Moana Rongo, said work to seal Mahia East Coast Road would not only benefit Rocket Lab. The hideous road was a safety hazard for locals, including children who needed to travel along it to school, Mr. Rongo said.
Kids travel sometimes an hour and a quarter to go to school, you know. My daughter self travels, you know, 55 minutes every morning on the roads, and it's dangerous with the more trucks that are coming on and that. So great from an economical sort of point of view, but, you know, just the safety side of it, you know, so that's important to us.
Mr. Rongo did sound a warning over the peninsula's growth needing to be coordinated and sustainable. References to the boost in visitor numbers better road access would allow prompted murmurs of dissent from some members of the audience at Tua Huru Marae.